how many need to be vaccinated before we start seeing hospitalizations go down?
Well, Shepard, that's going to take a while. It's not going to help us out of the current surge that we're in. We're going to have to get through this surge based on the measures that we know work. What will be very important for that is Congress passing a relief bill next week that could make it easier on the businesses and the workers who need to be distanced to make it easier for all of us to get through the next couple of months. But beyond that, by the time these high-risk individuals, healthcare workers, start getting vaccinated, then other over 65 individuals, other people in a larger group at bigger risk for COVID get vaccinated in January and February. By that time, we should be past any big surge like the one that we're experiencing now. Hopefully, this will be the last one.
Well, we can hope. Doctor, this is an enormously complicated thing, the vaccine distribution. Special freezers, dry ice, multiple shots. Are there specific areas in which you have real concerns about this process?
I think, Shepard, for the first couple of weeks, the federal government has put a lot of effort and oversight into making sure that the first round of vaccines get to frontline healthcare workers and get to people in nursing homes in collaboration with CVS and Walgreens. That looks like a pretty tight operation. As we move beyond that, in January, where we're going to try to vaccinate more people in high-risk groups like those over 65, people who may be harder to reach. That's where the state collaboration and outreach to communities, engagement of providers and IT systems and so forth are going to become more important. That's where you're likely to see some more bumps. But again, lots of effort going into that planning right now.
Dr. McClellan, I know you're on the board of Johnson & Johnson. They have a vaccine of their own, which will likely go up for emergency use authorization in the early part of the new year. What sort of an advantage would we get as a society against this virus if there were another vaccine in the pipeline?
Well, fortunately, Shepard, there are more vaccines, too. There's also the AstraZeneca vaccine, sure, which has some issues. They've had some bumps in their clinical trial designs, but they're likely to get approved in Europe in the not-too-distant future, and they're conducting further studies in the U.S. J&J has been able to accelerate its clinical trial because, unfortunately, there's so many cases in the United States, it doesn't take as long to figure out if a vaccine works. So we're going to have a significantly larger supply, if everything stays on track, significantly larger supply of vaccines by February, March, where we could see 50 million Americans a month potentially getting vaccinated, which means potentially broad access to vaccines for most adults that might want it by later on in the spring. So not that far away, certainly much better than we were expecting a few months ago.
It's really incredible. You know, we're all fatigued. It's been a long 9 months. But when you consider the history of vaccine rollouts compared to what's happened now, it's really, history will reflect that it was incredibly fast.
It is incredibly fast, but there one other thing that I do want to emphasize matters for this is what Congress does. Congress, as you know, is considering another bill to provide assistance with vaccine distribution, with testing, with helping businesses that have been affected by this latest surge. Those steps are going to make the distribution go better. They're going to help us get the surge in cases down faster, and that means significantly faster recovery, getting back to normal, getting back to business as usual.
Sure hope Congress can get their act together on something. Doctor, it's great of you to be here. Thanks very much. Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.